Hello fellow modelers, I hope everyone is fine and doing okay. The last week I had quite enough spare time to utilize on my bench, so I am back with a new modeling adventure. This time with a World War II military vehicle, a Krupp protze, 1 ton, 6x4 kfz.69 towing truck in 1/35 scale from Tamiya with kit number 35-59. According to Scalemates, this kit is a rebox from an older kit of Tamiya, which was initially released in 1978. Tamiya updated and added some new parts and re-released it in 2003. Upon opening the box, you will find 6 plastic sprues, 1 sheet of water slide decals and a small piece of wire. All these parts are more than enough for you to build the truck, 4 figures with various accessories and an anti-tank gun. More specifically, a pack 3.7 centimeters. So now that I have finished building this kit, what I have to tell you about it is that it is a typical Tamiya kit, which means don't drop the box because the kit is going to be assembled on its own. Every part is crisp, clean and nicely engineered, which makes building this truck a breeze. Everything falls together as easily as you hear it. The instructions separate the truck into 4 sub-assemblies, which make it easier to detail paint, especially for modelers like me who do not own an airbrush, and paint everything with a hair stick so the truck won't be an issue at all. As for the 4 figures now, 2 of them, and I am talking about the passengers located at the rear of the vehicle, are newly tooled, which means that they are better detailed than the driver and the co-driver, which obviously are made from older molds and their details are not so crisp. For me, that was not a problem. I try to paint them as good as I can and the result is good enough for my standards. Now about the anti-tank gun I mentioned before. Although the sub-assembly was relatively easily, the parts was too small and fiddly for my sausage fingers, so after trying, I didn't like the result, so I didn't finish it at all. Either way, I got the kit mainly because I like the truck and because it is a vehicle you don't see often built it, and not for the anti-tank gun, which I have to admit, it was a nice addition. Finally, this kit's decals give you the option to choose between 4 types of markings. I personally chose the 1941 Belarus type. The decals go down easily and they are thin enough so you can cover the edges with 2 thin layers of varnish. That was everything that I have to say about this build. I can recommend this kit to every type of modeler, although it needs some attention. If you stick to the instruction, you can easily take it in a few days' time and have fun with it, either you are an amateur or an advanced modeler. As always, fellow model builders, I want to thank you for watching this video. If you have found this build helpful or interesting at all, please leave a like and a comment with what you've liked or didn't like in this video. If you want to see more builds and support me, please consider subscribing to my channel. You can even click the bell notification button below so you won't miss any of my new building adventures. Before I go, I forgot to mention that whoever is interested to a brief history about today's build and the colors that I have used, please check the description below. That was all for today's building adventures, fellow modelers. Keep painting and building interesting projects. See you next time. Bye bye.
This is Jack and back on scene.
The new sound of the 80s. Suddenly you hear it everywhere. It's all beat and all talk. It tells you a story and makes you want to dance. Steve Fox examines an overnight phenomenon, rapping to the beat.